Mom? Did you hear what I said? Mom?
Bianca, you need to hurry and get dressed. We're so horribly late, and it wasn't easy to pull this press conference off, you know, so close to Christmas. Those reporters, those photographers, I know they want to get home to their families. And to keep them waiting, this would be unforgivable.
Mom, can't you even look at me? Please, turn around, face me, face who I am. Anymore to be someone I'm not.
I told your Uncle Jack that sending you to that rehab center was a complete mistake. And it was. I was right. I wish I had listened to my instincts. What that girl did to you, that horrible girl.
Who, Sarah? She didn't do anything to me.
Honey, of course she did. She's older than you are, and she preyed on you. She preyed on your youth and your inexperience.
No, we were friends. We were soulmates.
Oh, Bianca, you were sick. You were fighting a disease. You were scared. You were vulnerable. And she took advantage of you. She tried to confuse you, tried to get you to think that you're something that you're not.
That's not true.
Of course it is. I mean, I have no idea what she said to you to try to convert you.
She said she loved me. She still does. But we can't be together because she's afraid.
Afraid of what?
Afraid that her mother won't love her anymore. Because Sarah is not who her mom needs her to be.
That is Sarah's problem, Bianca. Not yours. Honey, I think that when you've had time to calm down and think this through logically.
Oh, what, Mom? I won't be gay anymore?
Stop it! Don't ever say that again! You're only 16 years old. The teen years can be very confusing. You're not even sure who you are.
I know what I feel and what I don't feel for boys.
Honey, how could you? You haven't even dated yet.
Mom, Leo is drop-dead gorgeous. All the girls want him, except me.
Well, honey, maybe he's just not your type. I mean, look at me. I've spent my life looking for Mr. Wright, but just because I haven't found him doesn't mean that I'm that way.
But I am.
Did I miss something along the way? I mean, I know that my breakup with Travis was very hard on you, that you were very angry and you acted out. But we got you the help you needed. And I didn't think that the damage was permanent.
Mom, I'm not a child anymore. I'm not acting out. This has nothing to do with you or Daddy or Uncle Jack.
Then what does it have to do with? I mean, you were perfectly normal before we sent you to that awful rehab center and then that girl.
Mom, Sarah did not make me gay. I've known that I've had these feelings ever since I can remember. I just wasn't sure what they were.
Honey, you're still not sure. I mean, you were fighting an eating disorder, and your self-esteem was non-existent. And then along came this Sarah, and she enlisted you to be her friend.
Mom, Sarah and I were more than friends. We were lovers.
I told my mother once that I would rather die than be like her. And she swore to me that someday my daughter would look me in the eye and say something just as hateful. But I never imagined that you could be this cruel.
You You actually think that I came out, that I told you that I'm gay, to hurt you?
I do nothing than try to please you, try to accommodate you. But everything I do is misunderstood. I mean, I gave you a party that any girl, well, it would be any girl's idea of heaven.
You mean any normal girl, right, Mom?
But you reacted as if you were being tortured, as if I were holding you up for public ridicule.
Because that's the way it felt. Mom, I'm not you. I'll never be you, and I have known that since forever.
I never have asked
Mom,
you.
Mom, stop dismissing me, please. You're not the only person in this room. I'm here, too. Your daughter is here, and she has feelings that matter, too.
Of course you
Mom,
do.
Mom, all my life, I have felt like I didn't belong anywhere to anyone until Sarah. For the first time, I felt at home with someone. I felt like I belonged, but I was also afraid.
Afraid of what?
Of you. Of how you would react if you found out about me. I was scared to death that you would be ashamed and embarrassed and disappointed. That's why I didn't want that stupid party. That is why I got drunk and I tried to make out with the captain of the boys' soccer team. I just wanted to please you, Mom. I just wanted to make you happy. I lived a lie so that you would stay tucked away in your comfort zone so that you wouldn't be ashamed if the whole world knew what you didn't want to admit, that your daughter is gay.
That's enough. I don't want to hear any more now.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive.
That was lovely. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Erica, why don't you and Bianca put on something warm and come join us? You know, troll the old Yuletide carol.
Oh, well, thank you, but we have other plans this evening.
Hey, Bianca, I heard you sing at the school the other night, and you were really, really good. I was wondering if you wanted to come sing some harmonies with us.
Not tonight. Some other time.
Bianca, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Laura.
Well, ho.
Jackson, it's good to see you. I'm a little worried about Erica. Something's not sitting right with her tonight. And
be a dear, why don't you see if you can find out what's troubling her?
You bet I will. You have a Merry Christmas, okay?
All right, same to
you.
Good night, Erica. I'll call you in the morning, okay? Find out what Santa brought you.
All right.
Merry Christmas, honey.
You do realize you have members of the press waiting for you.
I certainly do, yes.
Is there a problem?
No. Christmas is my favorite season.
Mom, stop. Stop pretending that everything is Santa Claus.
Come in, Jack. Please come in. Do we have to air our dirty laundry in front of the whole neighborhood?
I'm the one who's dirty, right, Mom?
What's going on here?
Sarah was here. Mom walked in on us.
I have to get out of here.
Oh, please don't.
Where are you going?
I told you I have people waiting for me. I can't let them down.
No, Mom, you can reschedule. Please, Mom, this is important to me.
Let me tell you something maybe you don't know about your mother. She spent most of her adult life looking for a man to replace her father. And now I think she's afraid.
Afraid of what?
That maybe you're looking for a woman to replace her.
That's insane.
Is it? Well, I don't know, I just thought I'd throw it out there. In my experience, the heart wants what the heart wants, and devil take the hindmost. I think you're just going to have to give your mother a little bit of time to get used to this whole idea.
Can't she see that I am still the same person?
No. Not now. Not yet. But she'll come walking back through that door, and the two of you will sit down, and you will work through this. And it will all work out eventually. I promise you.
Forgive me, please, for keeping all of you waiting.
Erica, where's Bianca?
Don't tell me Miss Young Enchantment's a no-show.
Well, now, you know how teenagers are. It seems that my daughter has a boyfriend who is much more important to her than a modeling career.
So, Enchantment mother-daughter campaign is off.
Steve, how long have you known me? I have never canceled a campaign. I'm not going to start now. No, I'm just going to change the focus a little bit.
How?
Well, for one thing, my daughter Bianca will be working behind the scenes.
Where she belongs.
And I am very pleased and very excited to announce that I am going to be returning to the spotlight, and I will be Enchantment's top spokesmodel.
Bravo! Viva Erica!
About time. I'm so glad you've come to your senses.
Well, thank you, Bruce. If you all will just give me 2 minutes, I promise then I will be all yours. Excuse me.
Jack, it doesn't bother you that I'm gay?
No. No, not at all. You know, we're about to celebrate the birthday of a very important man. A man who was the embodiment of love and acceptance and compassion. I couldn't love you any more if you were my own daughter. And there's nothing that would ever change that. Oh, come here, sweetie.
I wish Mom felt the way you do.
Oh, we love you so much.